Namaskar everyone. So this is the next video related to chapter number first, that is called Introduction to Accounting. In chapter number first, we already discussed the definition of accounting first, second, what is accounting, accountancy, bookkeeping, characteristics of accounting, advantages and disadvantages of accounting, and how your accounting cycle works. So in this chapter, the next topic we are going to discuss here, that is called characteristics of qualitative information. So what are the various characteristics of qualitative accounting information? The first one is that is called verifiable. As we already know that accounting information must be verifiable. Verifiable means it must be factual or verified. So there is a number of source of document through which we can verify the accounting information. There are number of source of document are like debit note, credit note, check, bill, invoice. There are number of source and document. So we must say that each and accounting information must be verified with the proper source of document. That is called proof, or we can say evidence, so that the users of accounting information will get the proper and the correct information. Second one is relevant. As you already know that accounting information is relevant. It must be relevant for the users, internal and external. We can say management, employee, or we can say potential investors, government, researchers, all need the accounting information. So accounting information provide the relevant information. Relevant information means that which is needed by the users of the accounting. All irrelevant information and insignificant information need not to disclose. So this is the second characteristics of qualitative accounting information, that is called relevant. Now the third one is understandability. Accounting information should be presented in such a way that it can be understood by each and every person, or we can say by the users of accounting information. That is called, we can say that presentation of financial statement, trading P&L and balance sheet should be presented in such a way that it can be easily understood by the users of financial statement. Now the fourth one is, that is called comparability. We can say comparison also here, that accounting information should be presented in such a way that the user can compare the figure of 1 year with the figure of previous year, or we can say the figure of current year with the figure of the previous year. So that is called comparability. And the last one is faithful presentation, that accounting information should be presented the true and the fair view of the accounting information, means the correctness and the reliability of the accounting information. So this is all about the various types of characteristics of qualitative information, or we can say characteristics of qualitative accounting information, that is called reliability, verifiable, comparability, understandability, and faithful presentation. Now the next topic is, that is called role of accounting. Now there are various types of role of accounting. So first role of accounting is accounting as a language. Why accounting is viewed as a language? Because it records all the business transaction which is communicated to the users of accounting and which provide the information regarding the business to the users of accounting. So accounting viewed as a language. The second role of accounting is accounting as a transaction, or we can say recording. So accounting as a historical record, because it record all the transaction related to business in a chronological order, that is called date wise. So that why accounting is viewed as a historical record. Third one is accounting help us in determining the net profit. As we already know that through accounting we can determine whether the business is in profit or loss. So that can only be possible through the help of accounting. So accounting help us in determining the net profit or loss of the business, as well as the exact reason behind the profit and loss of the organization. Fourth one, accounting help in determining the financial position. as we already know that we can determine the financial position through the use of balance sheet. And balance sheet can be possible only when we have a proper accounting information. So accounting information help us in determining the financial position, that is called the position of asset and liability, as on particular day, that is called 31st March of every year. So the fifth role of accounting is accounting as a service provider. Accounting viewed as a service provider because it provides all the information which is needed to the users of accounting information, that is called external and internal user. And last one is, it provide as an information, or we can say accounting as an information system, because it provide all the information that is called quantitative information related to the organization, to the users. So this is all about the role of accounting information. So this is the end of the chapter. Thank you so much.